There's some big plants in front.
Okay.
Here we go, the big plants. Those are little conventional leaves. And you can actually grow them. They'll like air root. And then you can see, do you see a little? Yeah, that's a little baby. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's new growth coming up. They're like mother of pearls.
Is that the Cadagensis?
Yeah, this is Calentio. This is Calentio. But Calentio, remember, they have like little
plantlets?
Yeah. Outside, and you can just grow them. You just take a leaf, like this. Well, it's already starting to, see, it's getting a little tight there. It's already leaping up.
Oh, yeah.
So we get new growth from there.
So do you know how they make these things, these kind of monstrous variations on... Like on this, is this an Echeveria?
Oh yeah, that's a mutation, that's right. They've hybridized it. There is a hybridizer out in, I think, San Diego who does that, yeah. And those are Echeveria hybrids. Like these are called Blue Curls right here.
Mm-hmm.
And those are called Etna. Like Mount Etna, Volcano Mount
sure.
Etna. Yeah, that's
it. Looks like a wart.
Yeah, it's like a little wart, it's like a little mutation.
It's coming here too.
I have one way over there that's really, like, you can see a lot of that, the mutation over there. It's right over there.
I have another question as well.
Oh, sure. Uh-huh.
My understanding is that even cactus can get sunburned.
Yes.
Uh-huh. And if you have them at home, where there's a lot of sun, how should one treat them?
Well, what we usually do is, if you don't have a patio or shade cloth,
yes.
You could move like a large plant and kind of make it kind of hovering over it. That might help too.
Okay.
And also, you might have to just kind of tuck it in and then way inside. It's only certain ones I need that, you know, like catechure. Just tuck it inside. And, you know, that should be okay.
Well, tell me if you disagree, but on that subject, I've found that a lot of people find that one of the most difficult places to plant is in northern exposures where they're in full shade for half the year and full sun for half the year. And I've kind of found that succulents are one of the most adaptable to that. I think kind of a lot of other plants that really need the full sun won't make it through a shady winter, but that the succulents are a little more. They might get a little spindly and the colors may change a bit, but they seem to come through okay.
Yeah. Oh, that's true. You know, I find that some plants underneath the table and stuff like that, they're still surviving, but they are kind of spindly, and then you just cut them, you know, and then start. That's true.
But I mean in the ground.
In the ground, yeah. Oh, can I introduce some Jeff now?
Yes.
Oh, hi Jeff. This is Jeff.